I've just come back from work and I thought I'd record a video for you about how I got into medical school. So I got into medical school as a graduate and I'll be telling you about my story. So going back to me as a child, I always wanted to be a doctor and I didn't know why. Every time someone would ask me, what do you want to do when you're older? I would say, I want to be a doctor. And they'll be impressed, but I just had no idea why. I later realised it was because I enjoy leadership, I enjoy working in teams, I enjoy problem solving, and I just generally enjoy biology and the human body. So basically medicine. So when I was 16, 17, I was getting to that stage where I had to start choosing my O-levels and applying for medicine. I was very oblivious to all of the requirements, and some of these requirements were quite new. For example, when I applied, the UK CAT was fairly new. Had no idea about it before the last month that I had to sit it. Same with the BMAT, same with the interviews, with the personal statement. And my school wasn't very familiar with students applying for medicine, which I think it helps when they do, because they know exactly how to prepare you and they can guide you in what to do if they've had previous successful candidates, and they could just tell you to follow in their footsteps, for example. But my school didn't, and I was one of the first to apply. So they weren't very helpful in terms of preparing my personal statement and preparing me for interviews, which isn't their fault, I guess, you know. But that just didn't really help. So I didn't have any work experience. I think in my personal statement I just wrote about my personal experiences in life and how that once helped me decide I wanted to do medicine. And even though I got the grades, it was not successful. So my UK CAT was really bad, not surprising, because I didn't really have time to prepare for it. I know you can't really prepare for the UCAT, but just getting familiar with the format and BMAT, etc. So one interview that I did get that year, surprisingly, was in Cambridge. So at that time, I'm not sure if they still have it now, Cambridge had a scheme where if you came from a disadvantaged school, so a school that was performing low in their borough, then you'd be considered separately than other students, because essentially your achievements are seen higher than those, for example, who went to better schools or private schools or had private tuition. So they gave me an interview through that scheme, and I went through like three mini interviews on the same day. And I actually got through the first stage. I wasn't accepted outright, but I got put in something called a pool, where if any of the colleges had spaces, they could take me out of this pool of students and accept me. And that didn't work. So I got that far, but then I got a letter saying, you know, the classic, very sorry, blah, blah, unsuccessful, blah, blah. So at the end of my first year of application, so at the end of sixth form, I was left empty-handed, and I was determined. I thought, I've got the grades, I know where I went wrong, I didn't have work experience, I didn't prepare for my UK CAT, so do you know what, I'm going to take a year out and I'm going to reapply. So I did that, and this time round I got a job at a pharmacy. I started volunteering at a hospital, so I was helping the catering staff and just doing like patient feedback questionnaires on an iPad down in the clinics. So unless you've actually gone through the hospital and got specific work experience where you have CRB checks, etc., you're not actually allowed to be involved in any of the clinical work or shadow any clinical stuff, which was fine. I wasn't expecting to anyway. So I did that, and then I worked for my UK CAT. I got a better score than last time, which a score that it was a decent score. It wasn't high, but it was something that I wouldn't be embarrassed with applying for certain medical schools except the UK CAT. And I did the BMAT. So at the time I wanted to get into UCL, and UCL wanted a specific score on the written component of the BMAT to secure an interview. So I didn't get that, and UCL was the only place I applied for with the BMAT, so that option went. also one mistake that I did was when I applied to Nottingham, I noticed afterwards, obviously, that they wanted an A for chemistry, whereas I had a B, and I hadn't noticed that that was that on their entry requirements. They did say AAB, but apparently they specified that they want the chemistry to be an A. So that was an outright, you know, rejection, and I was quite annoyed at myself for that because it was my fault, to be honest. And I think that year I got an interview with St George's, and because I'd gotten so far at that stage, I was so panicked. I was thinking, this is it, you know, this is the interview. If I get past this, now I'm going to get into medical school. And it was just so much pressure, and I was stuttering, and I was just misinterpreting questions and just replying back with stupid, irrelevant things. And I wasn't very surprised that I got rejected. But so I got through, I can't remember what my fourth option was, but essentially I got rejected again. And at that point, I was very unsure about why. I'd done my work experience. I'd improved my personal statement by getting some of the doctors on the wards to read them. I'd improved my UK CAT, and I was just lost, you know. I wanted to do medicine, and medicine is the only thing I ever wanted to do. So I felt so lost. I was like, what do I do with my life? Where do I go? How do I direct myself? Do I reapply? Do I just go do another degree? Do I completely forget about medicine? I've tried twice now. And another thing is, it's a bit, I felt embarrassed because people around you know that you're a high achiever and they know that you're applying for medicine. And when it comes around to people asking you, so, oh, what happened? I don't know, for me, I just felt it was such, like all my achievements and all my hard work just went to waste. And that's such a bad way to think about it, because getting into medicine or doing medicine isn't a definition of your achievement and how good you are academically and, you know, how good of a person you are. But my 18-year-old self at that moment was just so disappointed, so embarrassed. So I thought, I got into UCL, I got into biomedical sciences at UCL because that was my fifth option. So that's what I did. So I started, and the first few months were quite hard, just generally adapting to university and its way of teaching and the requirements. But because it was so heavily like biology and biochemistry and modules which are quite similar to what medics do in their first year, and I was really upset thinking, you know, some medical students are sitting a few lecture theatres away from me and they're learning literally the exact same things as I am right now in first year. And I'm not one of them. I'm just doing biomedical sciences. And that was quite hard. But then I soon kind of got out of that. And I was, you know, indulging in my work. And I made friends. And first year passed and second year passed. It all went quite quickly, actually. And I was doing well, which was motivating me and making me feel good with what I was doing. So come to the end of second year, some of my friends were applying for medicine. And they said, why don't you apply? And I was just so disheartened with the first two times that I'd applied that I was a bit scared too, because I didn't want that feeling of rejection again. But I thought, you know what, third time lucky. If I get in, I get in and I'll do medicine and it's meant to be. If I don't, then I'll do something else. I've got a degree, I'll do teaching, which is something that I also really enjoyed. You know, I can do something now, and I'm a bit wiser, where I didn't feel like I was in a black hole and I was lost. I actually, you know, thought I could do something. So yeah, that's what I did. We all applied, and I resat the UK CAT again. I did the BMAT again. So in terms of what I did differently, so obviously, apart from the fact that I had a degree, and I was applying as a graduate, what I did differently was not just focus my work experience in like just a hospital setting. I tried to do different things. So the first thing I did was go to volunteer with a charity kind of that gives dance lessons for children with disabilities. So we were just volunteering and supervising the kids whilst they were preparing for their end of year show. So I was there once a week and helping with that, which was quite fun, apart from getting slapped in the face by one of the kids whilst they were on stage because they were a bit overexcited and everyone saw it. It's quite embarrassing but funny as well. I was never angry with the child, you know, she had autism and it wasn't something she meant. But it was a nice icebreaker that I used in the interview, so it wasn't all bad. And then I did some volunteering work at a nursing home. So this nursing home had like activity days on a Wednesday, I think. And they wanted volunteers to come on that day to just help pack things away, you know, just coordinate things and supervise people. So I did that, which was quite nice. And then on top of that, I done some work experience at a GP. So the way I went about it was I didn't go to admin and get put on a list and, you know, fill out loads of forms. I just went straight to my own GP. I booked an appointment like I would if I had a problem, medical problem. And I went to see him and I said, look, I'm going to apply for medicine and I really want work experience at the GP practice. Would you help me? And he was one of the partners of the GP, which is quite important. And so he has a say. So, you know, he went straight to admin, explained the situation, and he got everything rolling. So within 2 weeks, I was sitting in his office with him and observing him, like examining patients and seeing patients, which was quite nice. And I think, what else did I do? I think I did some more volunteering work in a hospital. So in general, I got a big variety of experiences. So I got kids, I got the elderly, I got GP practice, I got a hospital setting. So I had a lot to talk about in my interview. And then, so like I said, I sat the BMAT again, and thank God that time I did meet the score for the written component for UCL and I got an interview. And yeah, so what happened first? I think UCL was the first interview that I had, and I went to it and they treated me like any other student. They didn't treat me any differently just because I was already a UCL student, so it was the same. I can't quite remember the questions they asked me, but basically one thing that they did do was go through the written exam. So they actually get a copy of the BMAT exam that you do, the written part, and they use that in the interview. So they ask you questions about things you've written and just basically trying to start a conversation, trying to get a feel of what kind of a person you are and your strengths and weaknesses, etc. So I did that, and I didn't think the interview went particularly well. I actually thought I would have gotten rejected. So the week after, when I got like an email, you know, the dreaded email where it says, there's been a change to your UCAS, and I thought, oh God, either UCL have rejected me. No, I thought either somewhere has rejected me already because UCL can't reply to me this quick. Or something else has changed. So I went on and I saw that it said successful next to UCL, and I was ecstatic. But my friend, who also got a notification the same day, got a rejection from UCL. So I wasn't able to be so happy because she was upset, obviously, but inside I was just, you know, just happy that I actually, like, it happened. After so many years of applying and then just doing a different degree, it felt really odd. And then I got an offer from Southampton as well, so from their graduate course. So Southampton is one of the unis where, and on their graduate course, I think, they don't actually call you for an interview. They just use your UCAT score and your personal statement, and they either accept you or reject you. And so I got accepted from there as well without having to attend an interview, which was quite nice. So after I got Southampton and UCL, I just rejected all my other interviews. So I got an interview from Warwick, I think, which I, you know, declined because one, it was a bit far for me to travel. And also it would have been a lot of preparation because their interviews are more like OSCE based. So kind of you have different stations and you work in groups and there's people observing you. So it's not a one-to-one interview. And I thought, you know, I'm not going to put myself, I was in final year of biomedical sciences at that point. And I said, I'm not going to put myself through this stress when I already have two offers. So I rejected that. And I can't remember what the third one was now. But so I had two offers. One of them was Southampton for 4 years and one of them was UCL for 5 years. So UCL is usually a 6-year course. But if you have a degree, you have the option of skipping the third year, which is the intercalated year. And that's what I did. So I thought, should I go to Southampton and do 4 years and be done with it a year earlier? But then that meant moving out of my parents' home and then having to pay rent. So I chose to stay in London, one, because I didn't have to move out, two, because I already had friends from biomedical sciences also going to UCL, which was a bonus. And just, you know, London is the city that I grew up in, and I don't do very well with change. So I thought, you know, it's better for me to stay on. And looking back now, having done 8 years of UCL, so 3 years biomedical sciences and 5 years of medicine, I never got bored because it was always a different setting. There was always a different lecture theatre, and during the last 3 years we were in different hospitals all the time. So I can't say I got bored. And you know what? You do get wiser when you get older. When I look at myself when I was younger, I thought, why did you restrict yourself so much on this one thought that you wanted to do medicine? I know maybe it's easy to say that now that I've gone through it and I'm in my second week as a junior doctor, but the most comforting thing I think is just to say to yourself, if it's meant to happen, it will happen. No matter what you do, even the worst applicants get in, and that's because if it's meant to be, it's meant to be. And I think back as, why didn't I get in first time round? Even though the second time I applied, you know, I thought it was all right and I had a good chance. And reason being is, I don't think my 18-year-old self would have been able to cope with the stress of medical school. So, you know, other 18-year-olds do very well, but me, looking back, I don't think I would have been able to do well at medical school, but just being so naive and just being a stress head. So I probably would have got into medical school, but then not being successful and having to drop out, which would have been even worse for me, because I would have felt like even more of a failure. So having done another degree and just being wiser and just being familiar with the university setting really helped. And I thought, now that I'm a junior doctor, when I work, I'm sure there's going to be so many people who are like 23, 24, and I'm going to be like the one older and who's 27. But actually, I was surprised to see how many graduates they were, and actually doing graduate medicine is such a common choice. And if you apply for a medical school where it's 5 years, having a degree beforehand gives you extra points when you're applying for your junior doctor roles. So when you apply for the foundation program, I think I got like 3 or 4 extra points just for having a degree, and that just gives you a head start and a booster for everybody else, for example, that's applying, especially if you want to get into somewhere like London. So it really helped me. So yeah, I don't really know what else to say. If you've got any questions, leave them below and I'll happily answer them, because when I look back, I didn't get any help just because there weren't people around me that were applying, so it was quite difficult. But now that I've gone through it all and I've got the experience and I've gone through the ups and downs, I'm glad it happened this way. So if there's anyone who's thinking of applying as a graduate, or you know, you did maybe like you didn't fail to get in and you just wanted to do a degree before, that's absolutely fine. And if anything, it helps you in medical school because you're more mature. And now when I'm on the wards, I get a bit more respect than any of my other colleagues who are in the same position because I'm older, which is always nice. So yeah, I really enjoyed doing medicine as a graduate, and I didn't expect it to be like this. When I was 18, I thought I'm gonna get straight into medical school, be finished with it, I'm gonna start work, you know, get on. But life isn't always how you plan it to be, but in the end, eventually, it's fine. And when you look back, you can appreciate why things happened the way they did, and ultimately you become a doctor. So if it's something you want to do, don't be put off by failing. Come on guys, I failed like twice and I applied to medical school 3 times, and now I'm working in London, which is one of the most hardest deaneries to get into. So don't give up if you really want to, because you'll always regret it in the future. You'll always think, oh, why didn't I do it one more time? So yeah, let me know if you've got any questions and I'll happily answer them for you.